What if you could automate image descriptions with just a few lines of Java code? In this video, I'll show you how to leverage vision models with Ollama, which allows you to run large language models locally, combining them with powerful Java features like records and sealed interfaces and JUnified tests. Let's dive in. Here's the Ollama webpage, ollama.com. And you can see here, there's a nice little download button right on it. If you click on the download button, there are downloads available for Mac, for Linux, and for Windows. Once you've done the download and install it, you can verify that Ollama is available by going to localhost 11.4.34, and it says that Ollama is running. Once you have installed Ollama, what you need to do is to install some models. On the homepage, there's a models section, and the models lists models in order of, well, here they're featured. You can switch that to most popular if you'd like to see that, see the ones that are downloaded the most often, or you can switch to newest and see what's changed recently. Now there's a Falcon 2 model, a few Llama 3 variations, and a few Lava models inside there. These are all installed using the command line. As you can see here, the command is Ollama run and then the name of the model, or you could just do Ollama pull with the name of the model and just install it without actually running it at the moment. The nice thing is because it's running that little server, it actually points out on the GitHub repository that there is an API and you can access it through various endpoints. If I scroll down a little bit, you'll see that a request to the generate endpoint post to API/generate requires the model with a model name and a prompt and potentially, if you want, a list of images that are base64 encoded strings for multimodal models such as Lava, for example. There's some additional parameters you could add as well. The only one I care about right now is stream. If you set stream to false, then you'll get back a single response object rather than the entire stream of objects. What I want to do now is to go to IntelliJ here so that I can see the records that I've created in response to that structure. First of all, I have a class here called Ollama Records. And inside there, I have some records like one called Model List that has a list of Ollama model. And there are the properties that go with an Ollama model, including a details object that has additional features you can see. But this is where the cool part comes in. I've created a sealed interface, meaning an interface that can only be implemented by permitted classes. So I have a text request to go to that generate endpoint. That's why I call it Ollama generate text request. And an image request as well that is like the text request, except it also has the images inside it. So I will specify the model, the prompt, and stream parameters inside. You can see that the text request has just those three properties, whereas the image request has those three as well as the list of string here. The other neat thing you could do with records is to use this thing. This construct right here is what we call a compact constructor. Notice it doesn't have parentheses on it. This will get invoked when you call the regular constructor, and it gives you an opportunity to transform the data or validate the data. So what I'm doing is I'm saying if there is that images prompt or images property, then the list of strings here for the image request, then I will look at each image and say, is it base64 encoded already? If so, I'll keep it. Otherwise, I have a nice simple method to encode the image. In fact, here you see the isBase64 encoded method, the private method there, which basically just sets up a regular expression to find out if, in fact, it's already encoded. If not, it will upload the image, which presumably is local, and then create the base64 encoded version of it. Finally, here's the response that comes back. You get the model, the created at response. Here is the actual text that we want. A boolean done, which should be finished when we get our response back, and a few other integers or longs involved. If we look at the interface here, then I have one endpoint that allows me to get the various models that have already been installed on my machine, and one to invoke the generate endpoint using that Ollama generate request in the request body and getting back the Ollama generate response. Now remember, this is the sealed interface, the Ollama generate request. Prior to doing that, I had separate inputs for the text request and the image request. Either way, they'd be carried in the request body and they both return an Ollama generate response. But once I've added the sealed interface, now I can access everything all in one request. This is auto-wired into a service class in Spring. I have constants for several of the models, and there's the interface, which is brought in through the constructor. So I have a method to get all the models and just take a look at them. That returns a list of Ollama model. Here's the generate method, which takes in an Ollama generate request, and then I'll use the enhanced switch statement from Java to say, if this is an Ollama generate image request, I'll print out that I'm reading an image and then call generate with it. Otherwise, if it's a text request, I'll print out I'm generating text. Now, I don't really need the switch expression here because either way, the call is the same. But just to illustrate what can be done, I have that method in there. In the example here, I have a parameterized test called describe image that takes a model, generates the Ollama generate image request saying, what is this image? And there's my sample here, and getting a response, asserting it's not blank, and then printing it out. This actual image is this picture, which was generated using DALL-E 3 of cats playing cards. So to take a look at this thing in action, let me run that parameterized test. You'll see as it's running, each one is going to print out which model it's using, and then print the response and go on to the next one. It is in principle possible to run these in parallel, to actually load multiple models and keep them in memory, and to, in fact, send multiple requests concurrently to the same model if necessary. Although in this case, I'm using one request per model, so that wouldn't necessarily be such an advantage. That's not happening on this particular one. I'm simply running them consecutively, but in principle, it'd be easy enough to add parameters to change that behavior. Here's the response I get. Let me put on the word wrap here. And you can see with lava, it says, let me move that down a little bit. In this image, there are four cats, so I counted wrong. Various colors, one with a mix of calico and black fur, another with appears to be a tabby, and so on. They are sitting on a wooden floor around a coffee table. I don't see a coffee table. On the table, there are playing cards, a pack of cigarettes, which I also do not see, and a cup of milk, which, well, I see four cups. The cats seem relaxed and curious as if they have been casually arranged for this photographic scene. That's just regular llama. Now let's look at the next one. The one based on llama 3, lava based on llama 3, says the image captures a cozy scene of four cats. Again, can't count. Gathered around a table, each engaged in its own world. On the left side of the table, two black and orange cats are sitting upright, more or less. They seem to be engrossed in their surroundings or perhaps in a silent conversation. I don't know about that. In the center of the table, a calico cat is comfortably reclining on its stomach. Okay. Appears to be in a state of relaxation. And on the right-hand side, another black and orange cat is sitting upright like its companions on the left. Scattered across the table are several coffee cups, three white ones and a red one. Yeah, I don't see that either. Anyway, how about Phi 3? This one seems to do a bit better, although it's still got four cats. And two are upright and the other two have chosen to lay down and coffee table, etc. Again, I don't know if there's a coffee table there. My favorite's this one, Baklava, which says five cats. At least it counted right. And then the Moondream one, which is small but really nice, says it's a group of five cats, which is good, gathered around playing cards on the floor, which is good. The cats are sitting in various positions with some closer to the center and others near the edges. They appear to be engaged in an entertaining activity as they interact with each other or focus their attention on the cards. In addition to the cats and the cards, there is a cup placed nearby, possibly containing milk for one of the feline players. Okay, more or less. So, at any rate, that's what it looks like. That's how we were able to create the records and the sealed interfaces and execute with Ollama and do a parameterized test and everything. Hope you enjoyed that.
Hey there, Dev, it's time to tune in to Tales from the Jar, so let's begin. Java, come in and spring, oh my. Groovy breath and don't be shy. Tales from the Jar side, oh yeah. Crack open the code, let's take a ride. From design patterns to the latest trends. Your weekly tech toast that never ends.